Ehlers-Danlos syndrome. We're going to talk about what it is, the symptoms, the diagnosis, how to test for it at home, and the best treatment. We're starting now. Ehlers-Danlos syndrome is a group of inherited connective tissue disorders. These are characterized by a wide range of symptoms, but it's mostly known for its elastic skin. So if you pull your skin, it's loose. Your joints, I can't do it, but basically bending your elbow, bending your thumbs back, your fingers back, and fragile tissues. This wide range of syndromes is caused by various genetic defects in collagen and connective tissue. So for your skin and for your ligaments. Here's some interesting statistics. It affects both males and females of all ethnicities and backgrounds. One in about 5,000 people worldwide will get this, but it's said to be extremely diagnosed. So this means probably at least 100,000 people in the United States do have it. Some are undiagnosed. Diagnosis rates, historically, it's very, very underdiagnosed because there's a range. You can start to have it, and then you can have it a lot. Improved awareness and diagnostic criteria have led to increased diagnostic rates recently. Have you ever been in grade school or high school and there's a kid who can flip his eyelids, bend their fingers the wrong way, their elbows, their knees? That could be Ehlers-Danlos syndrome. But now there's more funding for this than ever. There's more Google searches than ever. And recognition and diagnosis of EDS is rising, not necessarily indicating higher prevalence, but people are becoming more and more aware of it. The most common type is hypermobility. The most common type is hypermobile EDS. It's considered the most common type, but again, hard to quantify. This means your joints can bend. The most dangerous type is vascular EDS. This carries the risk of complications like heart issues, aortic aneurysms, and the life expectancy is lower at about 48 to 55 years old due to risk of blood vessel rupture. So that can be scary. It could be really important to diagnose this. And it is genetic. So when you get it, it's a genetic defect in your body. And I think most importantly, we're going to go over a test that can be pretty useful that you can do at home. But there are different types. But number one is joint hypermobility. Can you bend your fingers back? Can you bend your elbow? So for example, I could bend my elbow pretty much up here with Ehlers-Danlos. This can cause joint dislocations and subluxations in your skin. If you grab your skin and pull it up, I can't really do that, but it stretches more than usual and returns to normal when released. Fragile skin. Skin that bruises easily, tears easily, and heals poorly, often causing thick scars. Do you have chronic pain, persistent or recurrent musculoskeletal pain, especially on the insides of the shins, bottom of the feet, heels, wrist, and this has no clear cause? Do your feet and ankles hurt all the time? Cardiovascular issues, especially vascular disease, and this could cause aneurysms, arterial dissections, but that's kind of at the very end of the process. And GI problems such as reflux, gastritis, diarrhea, constipation, and this can obviously get worse and cause worse issues. Dental issues, high palate, dental crowding, fragile gums that bleed, early onset arthritis, chronic joint disease, and fatigue. Are your muscles always sore? Your knees, your ankles, your feet most commonly. As a podiatrist, I see this all the time. And temperature regulation issues, heart rate issues, you always feel stressed, anxiety. These symptoms can range from very mild to very severe. Again, for me, I see them leg weakness, fatigue, shin splints, plantar fascia pain, bottom of the foot pain, very flat feet are extremely common. Diagnosis. Diagnosing Ehlers-Danlos syndrome involves clinical evaluations and family history. This is genetic. Call up your aunts, your uncles, your parents, your grandparents, if you have them. Ask, do you get flexibility? Do you have these skin problems? Are you hypermobile in your joints? If it's genetic, you may have a layer of Ehlers-Danlos syndrome. And then you can do genetic testing. So there's genetic tests that are available for cash pay now that you can even order from home. And you can go to your neurologist, you can go to your rheumatologist and get these done. But don't worry, I'm gonna go over the test that you can do at home. A physical examination. You can check for skin hyperelasticity. So grab your skin and pull it. Does it stretch? Does it pull? Do you have hypermobility? So for example, can you bend your thumbs back, your fingers back? I can't really do it. And scarring. If you cut yourself, this could be scarring. So we're going to talk about the Batten score, and this will quantify joint hypermobility. So the Batten test is a quick, simple screening tool. It's not meant to be relied on its own. Younger people tend to be much more flexible, and this does decrease with age. It looks at 9 different points, and they are as follows. 1 point for each little finger that can bend backwards 90 degrees. So it's 1 point for your little fingers if they can go back. So this is your little finger. I can't quite get it to 90 degrees. It would have to be something like that right there. So that would be up to 2 points. Your thumbs. Can your thumb touch your forearm? So can you get it all the way here? I can't quite do it, but that would be up to 4 points already if both thumbs can do that. Can your elbow bend backwards? So right here, if you can actually get your elbow to pop up, that would be another point. That's up to 6 points right there. What about your knees? Can your knees bend backwards? That's another 2 points. And you get another point if you can take your palms and put them down on the floor with your butt up in the air. I would actually get a point for that. I can do that because I keep my hamstrings flexible. I don't really think that one should count. So you can tell, little fingers, so your pinky, your thumb, your elbows, your knees, that's 8 points. And can you put your hands on the ground without bending your knees? That's a score of 9. Generally, if you can get at least a 4, I think I can get a 1 out of 9 by putting my hands down on the ground. That's a significant sign of hypermobility. It might make sense to do further testing for Ehlers-Danlos at that point, but despite its limitations, it's a pretty good test that's very valuable. In your medical history, do you have personal and family histories? Check with your relatives. Genetic testing. I mentioned there's a lot of genes, mutations. I won't get into the specifics in this video, but testing can now look for these. And other tests, these are not as frequently used, but a skin biopsy can check for how much collagen in your skin, a heart scan called an echocardiogram, or x-rays and MRIs to assess for your joints, and there are clinical criteria there. In the end, the diagnosis is made by a multidisciplinary team. You could have a genetic doctor, you could have a cardiologist, and another specialist like a rheumatologist or a neurologist who can take a look at some of this testing. What's the best treatment for EDS? The treatment goals are to manage the symptoms and prevent complications and improve your quality of life. Most people will live a long, healthy life unless you have the vascular type. And there's a lot of things you can do. But again, because it's a genetic problem, there's no cure now. There is gene therapy, there is nerve treatments coming out, and there is stem cell therapies, but none of them as of yet can provide a reliable cure. We're probably numerous years away, but if you're young, hold out hope. This might come within your lifetime for sure. Medications, so pain management, non-steroidal anti-inflammatory drugs like ibuprofen, acetaminophen, opioids can help. I don't really recommend these. I would say if you're having pain on your knees, your feet, your ankles, there's a lot of great creams out there that can be very beneficial. There's a lot of different nerve medications too. I have complete guides on nerve pain, chronic pain, how to take care of that, your diet, your supplements, your medications, and your creams. Check that out below. Cardiovascular medications. If you have the heart type, check with your cardiologist, but things like beta blockers can lower your blood pressure. That's very important. I have a guide on the top 15 things to get your blood pressure down. If you have acid reflux, there are medications you can take for that as well. But let's get to the treatments that are very effective. I see people mostly with joint problems like knee problems, foot problems, ankle problems. A tailored physical therapy program is the number one thing you can do. Muscle strengthening, keeping your muscles strong, is the most important thing that you can do. So definitely, if you can work out 2-3 times a week, it will change your life and you'll have unbelievable results. And it's safe, it's easy, and it's convenient. If you're really far along, you can do hydrotherapy. So water aerobics is very effective. If you're really, really far along, occupational therapy. So this is covered. People can come out to your house. They can help you with skills, different devices, bars in your shower, walkers, handlebars, different things, and I'm talking for my older patients, this can help decrease fatigue and prevent your joints from developing worse arthritis. But here's what's really effective. Bracing, orthotics, and shoe gear. This is the number one thing that I see for my patients especially. They did a study. If you wear an ankle brace while balancing on one foot, it will prevent your foot from flattening out. It won't stretch your knee, it won't stretch your ankle, it won't stretch your plantar fascia, and your balance is way better. Number two, orthotics. You can put these in your shoes. I put my favorites down below, but it prevents that fatigue, that stretching. The results are unbelievable. So with Ehlers-Danlos, take a look right here. So without the orthotic, look at how much it flattens out. Your knees, your shins, your plantar fascia, they have significant issues. But with the orthotic, take a look. I'm pushing down. It's not flattening out. So that maintains your arch. It doesn't stretch your ligaments. And the orthotic does a lot of the work for you. So orthotics are huge. Insoles are great. And these are low cost now. Huge improvements for your knees, your hips, your back, your feet, your fatigue, and that nerve pain. At the end of the day, you won't be as sore and you won't be as swollen. And great shoes. I'm a big fan of supportive shoes for Ehlers-Danlos. It will spare your lower extremity, I'm telling you. I'm a big fan of OrthoFeet. I actually work with them. That's a bias, but I love them. My parents have them. My relatives have them. I get them for everybody. They're slippers, they're shoes. But if you don't want to go with OrthoFeet, because granted, it is an orthopedic shoe, even though they're getting more stylish, there's great brands like Brooks, Hoka, On, Asics. There's a lot of great brands out there. I have all my favorite shoes down below. There's a lot of great options, but get that ankle brace, get that insole. I would start with the shoe, a good home slipper, get those insoles in there if that's not doing it, then get that ankle brace. And we're talking compression braces that are basically like a sock. It makes a huge difference. If that's not doing it, you can get a wheelchair, you can get a walker, you can get a cane. Most people don't need a wheelchair, but you gotta get up and you gotta move. The goal is to prevent you from having to go in a wheelchair later on in life. And diet and nutrition. Because this video is already so long, I won't go into it here, but check out all my nerve supplements, all my joint pain supplements, my arthritis supplements, the best diets for all these. I go in depth for all your pain, all your conditions. But specifically, I'm gonna point out a unique one here. Vitamin C is very suggested for improving collagen synthesis and tissue repair. So for Ehlers-Danlos, collagen and vitamin C are two great supplements. So get your collagen in and get your vitamin C in. And look at lifestyle modifications. If you're going on long jogs, maybe switch to biking. If you're on your feet standing all day, do your best to get a work from home job. Your joints, your knees, your hips will thank you throughout your life. Avoid high impact activities that increase the risk of joint injuries. Because at the end of the day, this is not curable. So you have to change your life. And the beauty is, these days, there's so much to accommodate with. Working from home, computer jobs, there's a lot of different options because you can destroy your life if you're in the wrong profession.